Under normal circumstances, the Long March 5B is designed to transport payloads to low orbit, after which it would find its way back to the Earth's atmosphere where it will be burned by heat from the friction of the air. However, this Chinese booster rocket has somehow managed to survive getting destroyed in the Earth's atmosphere on a couple of occasions. This could be extremely dangerous, especially if it descends on a populated area, but China could care less. Attention everyone! A new candidate has joined the space race. From planning a mission to Mars to building its own space station and shooting down satellites in space, China's participation in the world beyond has increased significantly in recent times. So, how about we tell you everything China has been up to in space and the dangers that Chinese rockets pose to the rest of the world? China hopes to one day become the king in space, and officials in Beijing have sworn to do everything it takes to achieve this goal, emphasis on everything it takes. Obviously, to fulfill this dream, China would have to first break the duopoly that the United States and Russia have created in space. And so far, China is not shying away from it. In fact, Beijing is chasing down Russia and the United States at full speed, and there's nothing to suggest that it won't overtake one or both of these countries in the near future. However, this untamed drive and passion to become a dominant force in space could turn out to be a dangerous adventure not only for China, but for other countries around the world. On the 2nd of August, 2022, debris from a Chinese Long March 5B rocket made an uncontrolled re-entry into Earth's atmosphere after delivering the latest module of the Tiangong space station. Thankfully, the 5-meter charred ring, which appears to be the rocket's core stage, landed some few meters away from villages in Indonesia and Malaysia. No casualties were recorded, but the level of irresponsibility on China's part cannot be overlooked, especially because it is slowly becoming a recurring event. Just 2 years ago, pieces of a Chinese Long March 5B fell over areas in Ivory Coast and damaged several buildings. Experts have come down hard on Beijing with heavy criticism from different quarters. Under normal circumstances, the Long March 5B is designed to transport payloads to low orbit, after which it would find its way back to the Earth's atmosphere where it will be burned by heat from the friction of the air. However, this Chinese booster rocket has somehow managed to survive getting destroyed in the Earth's atmosphere on a couple of occasions. This could be extremely dangerous, especially if it descends on a populated area, but China could care less. Other spacefaring countries and agencies always go out of their way to ensure that the debris from their rockets or missile launch is diverted to a safe area away from populated cities. In fact, two of the world's biggest space exploration agencies, NASA and ESA, both hired professionals to track space debris, and as soon as they get hints of any threats, they move quickly to mitigate the risk. But even they have not been caught napping a few times. Fragments from different American and European rockets have been found close to populated areas in the past. Private aerospace companies are not innocent as well. The biggest of them all, SpaceX, was in the news recently after debris from a Dragon capsule was found in a grazing field in Australia. About a year ago, a pressure vessel from a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket landed on a farm in Washington, creating a 4-inch dent in the ground, but thankfully, no casualties were recorded. These mistakes are bound to happen, but it is how we respond to them that matters. For instance, China has a space debris tracking department as well, but with everything we've witnessed so far, it's hard to tell if the office is functioning. Currently, there are well over 500 million pieces of debris in space. However, the Department of Defense's Global Space Surveillance Network is only able to track about 27,000 of them. And China is irresponsibly adding to that tally. In 2010, Beijing blew up a Fenyang 1C spacecraft in space, leaving behind over 3,000 bits of orbital trash which could have entered Earth's orbit and landed on anybody, perhaps even you. To be fair to China, they're making some moves in the background to clear up that debris. But who will clean up the rest? NASA had previously discussed the possibility of using a laser broom to sort of sweep space debris out of the lower orbit. But the project was abandoned due to the Outer Space Treaty that prohibits the use of laser weapons in space. The Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, JAXA, also made an attempt to collect trash using an electronic space net, but the device that was meant to deploy the gadget suffered technical issues, and that ultimately was the end of the project. But in recent times, there seems to be some breakthrough in attempts to develop technologies that can be used to collect space debris, at least by private companies. One notable example in this regard is the Surrey Satellite Technology, which was launched in 2018. This project featured a number of trials and collection methods, including one that saw scientists use a harpoon to harvest space debris earlier this year. Japanese space sustainability company Aeroscale is also testing a magnetic catch-and-release satellite that recovers space junk before sending them into a safe deorbit path. NanoRax, a space hardware provider, has also joined the quest, but with a different approach. In all, it appears that private aerospace companies have a more hands-on approach to tackling this problem, which is a good thing anyway. It doesn't really matter who solves it as long as we don't have to wear helmets out of the house every morning to avoid getting hit by space debris. But there's a twist to this whole story. If you have reached this far in the video, we would like to give you a huge thanks. You can extend your support by subscribing to the channel and turning on that notification bell so you don't miss any of the content we upload. Comment down below, "I subbed," for your chance to be entered in our monthly shoutout giveaway. While efforts are ongoing to clear the existing trash in space, China's radical space exploration policy means more debris will be deposited over time. In 2020, the Chinese government spent an estimated $13.35 billion on space activities alone, a sharp increase from the $1.7 billion spent in 2009. This signifies their ambition to become a dominant force in space. Although that lump figure is only half of NASA's space budget, China certainly has some short-term results to show for it. In 2019, China's Chang'e-4 lunar lander became the first spacecraft to touch down on the Von Karman crater, also known as the far side of the moon. This prompted NASA Chief Bill Nelson to raise an alarm that there might be an ulterior motive behind the mission. "We should be very concerned that China lands on the moon and says, 'It's ours now, and you stay out,'" he said. China has since denied those reports, insisting that the accusations are false. However, their pace in exploring the moon and other celestial bodies has increased even further. In 2020, China's Chang'e-5 lunar landing and sampling mission found evidence of water on the moon twice, which is a huge boost for our quest to find habitable places outside of Earth. Beijing hopes to conduct two more lunar landing and sampling missions by 2024 using Chang'e-6 and the Chang'e-7. Away from the moon, China has some interplanetary ambitions as well. The Chinese Tianwen-1 mission, consisting of an orbiter and a rover named Zhurong, has been on Mars since 2021, performing different tasks. China plans to launch a manned mission to the Red Planet by 2033, as well as three more trips in 2035, 2037, and 2041. But before then, the country hopes to complete the Tiangong space station. As part of the mission, a high-tech space telescope called Juntian will also be launched. The Juntian space telescope will orbit with Tiangong and will regularly dock for refueling and maintenance. According to reports, the space station will be officially launched towards the end of 2023 and will serve as a base for Chinese scientists to carry out experiments and life sciences, microgravity research, astronomy, earth science, and new materials and space technology. We expect the Long March 5B rocket to play a key role in all of these missions, as well it will be saddled with the responsibility of transporting modules of the space station and other necessary payloads to lower orbit. But that would also mean more uncontrolled re-entry into Earth's atmosphere by the Long March 5B rocket, which has a tendency to escape the atmosphere and cause damage to humans on Earth. And as we've seen countless times, China isn't really bothered about it. They just want to toss these powerful rockets into the air and get the job done in outer space, regardless of where the debris lands. As long as their work in space is on schedule, nothing else matters. What do you make of this situation? Is China being too aggressive in its space exploration efforts? And what would be the right sanctions? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section. Be sure to check this video over here.